As most IT professionals know, WinPE is an essential tool for allowing the deployment, maintenance, and recovery of Windows installations. In this video, I am going to cover creating a custom bootable WinPE image using the latest Microsoft Windows Assessment and Deployment Kit, ADK. We'll cover the following topics: installation of Windows ADK and the Windows PE add-on, how to create a basic WinPE ISO, how to create a custom WinPE ISO with background, PowerShell, and applications, converting the WinPE ISO into a bootable USB drive using native Windows tools. Download the latest version of the Windows ADK and the Windows PE add-on. If you have a special use case, then download the ADK that is applicable to your environment. Install Windows ADK. If installing to other systems that do not have internet access, select the option to download for installation on a separate computer. Otherwise, click Next. Read the privacy information, select your option, and click Next. And being we have all read and agreed to the terms of the license agreement, we'll proceed with Accept. If you want the minimum number of features necessary to create the WinPE, select only Deployment Tools. We can add other Windows ADK features later. Once the installation is complete, exit the installer. Install the Windows PE add-on following the same prompts as earlier. After the installation, and as a precaution, make a backup copy of the original WinPE.wim located in this folder. Right-click on Deployment and Imaging Tools Environment and select Run as Administrator. Since we are in the Deployment and Imaging Tools Environment, we can enter the PowerShell shell to make things easier. To reduce the likelihood of introducing typo errors, set a few variables. To create a plain, basic, vanilla WinPE ISO, use these commands. Test the ISO by booting it into a virtual environment. A base WinPE is good, but it can be limited in what it can do. To overcome that limitation, we will build a custom WinPE image by adding the following. Add a third-party driver via an INF file, add Windows PowerShell, add a custom background image, add useful third-party applications, and add native SSH client capability. Right-click on Deployment and Imaging Tools Environment and select Run as Administrator. Start PowerShell and set our variables. In order to make any changes or customizations, we need to mount the base WinPE.wim image. Now, we're going to add a third-party driver to the WinPE image. This may be necessary in scenarios where the WinPE lacks a driver for a network adapter, for example. Check to see if the driver was successfully installed. Now, we're going to add Windows PowerShell and some other optional components to make our WinPE more useful. This is the main part of the customization. To replace the boring solid blue background with custom wallpaper, we have to replace the WinPE.jpg of the mounted image. But first, we have to change the security permissions to allow us to replace it. Navigate to C/WinPE_AMD64 mount/Windows/System32. Right-click the WinPE.jpg file and select Properties, Security tab, Advanced. Next to Owner, select Change, change the owner to the Administrators group. Apply the changes, read and acknowledge the Windows Security dialog box if it appears, and exit the Properties window. Again, right-click the WinPE.jpg file and select Properties, Security tab. Click the Edit button, grant administrators full control, click OK, and exit the Properties window. Replace the WinPE.jpg with your own custom file. Likewise, you can use PowerShell to do all the hard work for you. We're going to add a few useful third-party applications. Under /WinPE_AMD64 mount, make a directory named apps and place the executables there. I'm adding 7-zip, Explorer++, PuTTY, Notepad++, and the full sysinternal suite. To add native SSH client capabilities, go to the win32_openssh GitHub page and download the latest release of openssh-win64.zip. Extract the contents of the zip file to winpe_amd64/mount/apps and run these commands. Since we have added PowerShell to our WinPE image, we can have it start upon WinPE boot. Once completed, we have to commit the changes, unmount the custom WinPE image, and create our ISO file. Test the custom ISO by booting it into a virtual environment. Notice the custom background and that PowerShell automatically started. From the command prompt, we can now issue native SSH commands, such as SSH, SCP, SFTP, or SSH-keygen. Here, I have initiated an SSH session into an Ubuntu instance. The added applications are located under X apps, 7-zip, Notepad++, sysinternals. To create a bootable USB using native Windows tools, see the video Create Bootable USB Drive Using Native Operating System Tools. After you mount, customize, commit changes, and unmount a WinPE image, the original WinPE.wim will have been changed. There are times you will need to start over with a clean, original image. In that case, use your backup copy and restore to WinPE.wim. I hope you enjoyed this video, learned something new, and found it useful. If you have any feedback, corrections, or suggestions, please let me know in the comments below. Please like, subscribe, and pass it on to others. And I thank you for watching.